There are many examples over the years of potentially great ideas that have fallen down by the wayside because of a lack of a coherent plan or roadmap. And we see a huge number of startups who spend a considerable amount of money only to find out they've done insufficient research and their business model is fundamentally flawed. So I think the general rule is if you fail to plan, you plan to fail. Now, a number of entrepreneurs and business owners are concerned that too much planning can hamper creativity and passion. But actually, I think if it's done properly, it has quite the opposite effect, and the management team can become quite inspired. I think there are a number of really key benefits that creating a well-executed business plan can bring to a company. The first, I think, is on a management perspective. Now, in doing your business plan, you should always include your full management team, and I think that creates a very much a team-building experience, a great ownership for the business plan going forward. It's also important to communicate your business plan, or at least the key elements, to your staff so they can understand the vision, the plan on how the business is planning to get there, and also how their roles and responsibilities feed into that. So it really does engender loyalty, motivation, and transparency within an organisation. I think another powerful reason is that it puts a stake into the ground. So it provides guidance that people can follow. Now you need to remember this is a rolling document. Business plans change and business strategies change, so you need to revisit it regularly. But when you do, I think what it does is that as you change your approach, it prompts you, because you're comparing it to your current business plan, to really evaluate and justify your actions, which I think every business will realise is hugely valuable. Some people think that a business plan is solely a set of numbers, 3 years worth of profit and loss account, cash flow and balance sheet. And I dread to think how many times I've sat down with a company for the first time and they've said, here's your business plan, and that's exactly what they give me. The financial side is solely the product of a business plan, and the actual plan itself is in the narrative. And that's really important for people to realise. In terms of drafting a business plan, it's very important to be clear and concise and make it a very compelling read. And you also need to think about who the audience is for your plan in advance. So is it internal? Is it for potentially a bank providing debt funding? Is it equity investors? You need to understand that at the start so you can draft it with their objectives in mind. Although there are a number of different views on how long a business plan should be, there is a fairly well-established methodology of the sections you would need to include, and it very much covers all aspects of your business. And I won't comment on each in turn, but what I will do is comment on some areas where I think businesses fall down. Now, the first section is the executive summary. As everyone will realise, the aim is to summarise the plan that follows. Very, very important that it's written so it stands on its own, as a number of people will read the executive summary only before deciding whether to read the rest of the plan. Another key area is the section on your team and management. You will often hear venture capitalists and private equity houses talking about they're investing in the management team as opposed to necessarily the business and the products. And therefore it's very important when you do a business plan is that you invest time in analysing your current management team and your management skills and requirement as the business grows. SWOT analysis is very commonly used in a business plan, and I'm a great believer in a good SWOT analysis. Where people often fall down is that although they have gone through the process of identifying the strengths and the weaknesses and the opportunities and the threats, what they don't then do is the really valuable piece in saying, well, these are the strengths and the opportunities and this is how we plan to leverage those, and these are the weaknesses and the threats and this is how we're going to mitigate those risks. And that's the really powerful part of doing a SWOT analysis. And as I said before, the product of the plan is the financial side. Very important that people know their numbers, that the assumptions of the financials is consistent with the rest of the plan, and use sensitivity analysis. People will often do a pessimistic view, an optimistic view, and something in the middle that they expect to happen. It's very important that management can understand those scenarios and what levers they can pull should they occur. But overall, it's very important that the business plan is clear and concise.